Welcome to DeWatt Academy. Today we will learn how to configure the EVS failover settings. Prerequisite you need. All EVS must be from same family. And should be updated with same firmware version. All EVS must have same username and password. All EVS should have same IP segment for real and virtual IP. All EVS must have same quantity of RAID groups. To prepare the setup, you need a number of main EVS connected to a network switch, and a standby EVS connected to same network. Then you can assign the real IP to all EVS, and prepare a set of virtual IP only for main EVS, which we will configure in cluster configuration. Now let's configure the EVS cluster. For failover configuration, login in failover EVS. Click cluster settings. Then click configuration. Now click add to register EVS in cluster. Start with adding sub-device first. Give it a unique name. For first failover EVS, you cannot change the IP address. For sub-device, it will automatically take current EVS IP address. Finally fill the password of failover EVS and click OK to confirm. Failover EVS shall be registered as sub-device. Now, click add again to register main EVS. Give it a unique name. Now fill the real IP address of EVS you want to add as main EVS. Finally fill the password of this main EVS and click OK to confirm. Similarly, you can add more main EVS in this cluster group. It is preferred to keep the same password for all main and failover EVS. Registered main devices shall be listed here. Now click Start Cluster to initiate the cluster group. Wait for failover and main devices to update the status. To confirm successful creation of cluster, log in any other online EVS. Click Cluster from left panel, and click Configuration. Here you will find same list of main and failover devices which we configured in failover EVS recently. Now let's learn how to set virtual IP address. To assign virtual IP, click Cluster IP in main EVS. Check to enable. Fill new IP details in the same range. Now each main EVS shall have two IP addresses. First is real IP, configured in network settings. Second is virtual IP configuring now in cluster settings. Finally click OK to confirm. Similarly, configure virtual IP in all main EVS. Make sure all virtual IP addresses must be in same range. Adding EVS in DSS Pro. Now register all the main EVS in DSS Pro with virtual IP. Login DSS web client. Click add to register EVS. Fill virtual IP of first main EVS. Fill password of same EVS. And click add. Give a unique name to this EVS. Under video channel, make sure the count is same as cameras to be registered in this EVS. Now click continue to add to register another main EVS. Similarly, register all main EVS with respective virtual IP address. Click encoder to get all EVS online. Configuration completed. It's time to test the failover. In live view under DSS client, load cameras for live view from any EVS, say EVS2. And disconnect EVS2 network cable to make it offline. It roughly takes 2 minutes for failover EVS to take over. Log in any of the online EVS. And check cluster configuration. You can observe, EVS2 is exception and failover EVS is under use. Also, you can check in DSS client. Now cameras for EVS2 are streaming from failover EVS. Also, you can check in EVS cluster. The replacement IP in failover EVS is same as EVS2 real IP address. You can also check the log for various details. Click search to see all the cluster logs. Also, you can see individual EVS details by clicking details for respective EVS under cluster configuration. Now you can reconnect the main EVS and log in again in any online EVS. It roughly takes 1 minute for main EVS to take control back from failover EVS. Check again in cluster configuration. The status of EVS2 will change from exception to backup, and then working. Now click record transfer. And click details to see the automatic records transfer progress from failover to main EVS. You can click refresh to update the status. Back in cluster configuration, now you can observe that failover EVS status changed to free. Here we will check if all the records transferred successfully. After few minutes, you can check back the record transfer. If progress bar shows 100%, failover EVS successfully transferred all the records to main EVS. You can also check logs for further details. Click search to load latest logs. Here you complete EVS failover configuration. Thanks for using the WA products.